This is Tom Bernacki, and today I'm talking about prebiotics and probiotics, the benefits, the lies, and the myths. What do prebiotics and probiotics actually do? I looked across YouTube. There's some decent videos, but there's not a lot of great videos going into the details, into the new studies. So we're going over all the new studies, if it's worth it, and what the benefits are to you, and we're starting now. This is the hottest site of research. All this money is going into investing and studying these gut bacteria. They provide immune benefits. They make you stronger. Autoimmune disease. They can synthesize vitamins. They can help with weight loss. We're going to cover so many exciting benefits that would benefit almost everybody. So these bacteria, they're gross. They're all over your skin. They're farting. They're pooping. They're creating byproducts. They're eating stuff off your skin. And not only are they over your skin, they're in our guts and our colons. I got sent a prebiotic called
PreticX.
Always on the hunt for great content. So I did a deep dive into prebiotics.
I'm so excited about this. Look at what's happening. The patents, the journal articles, they're going absolutely nuclear. This means companies are so focused on this. This is like the new gold rush.
And what the heck is a podiatrist doing lecturing you about this stuff? Well, my wife normally does this because she's a dietitian. That's her specialty, but she's not allowed to talk on camera and she's about to give birth in about a month. So she doesn't want to be doing this video, but she helped me in depth with this and I did my biochemistry master's in this stuff. So prebiotics and probiotics are crucial. The bacteria in our guts, there is an immense population, 100 trillion bacteria in our body, in our guts. So that is outrageous. That's more than the cells in our body. And it's a diverse community. It's called their gut microbiome. There's thousands of different species of bacteria. They have a genetic richness. This genetic material outnumbers our own human DNA 150 times. And each person's gut has a personalized ecosystem.
You can even track the genetics of your gut bacteria. So different cultures have different distributions of gut bacteria with pros and cons and different superpowers conferred by these bacteria.
Like a fingerprint, you can study that personalized microbiome and it's influenced by factors like diet, environment, and genetics. It's said that these bacteria can even create neurotransmitters like serotonin impacting our mood and our health.
This is all just so fascinating to me, but serotonin, GABA, this can actually impact your mood. Have you ever heard that your gut is your second brain? It kind of is. You have short-chain fatty acids as well, which are important for regulating your colon consistency, how watery or thick your poo is so you're not constipated, and immune modulation, highly associated with autoimmune disease, inflammatory conditions. There's just so much study on these. If you're abnormal here, consider prebiotics and probiotics.
And we have ancient residents. There are some evolutionary studies tracing back your gut bacteria to which country you've come from thousands of years ago. This is possible. It's also said that these bacteria can help with weight management, dietary influence, how quickly we digest and break stuff down. They are immune allies. That means they can play a role in our immune function. And they're vitamin producers. I've made some videos about vitamin K2, for example. Our gut bacteria can help convert that. Same with B vitamins. B12 vitamins, for example, are extremely important.
Our gut microbiome can make vitamin K and K2. I have some vitamin K2 videos, and this is a really hot topic because vitamin K2, is it made by gut bacteria? Check out those videos to see exactly how much, but it is a smaller amount. So vegans do get a little bit, but usually not what they need. The B vitamins, B7, B9, B12 is very important, B2, B3, but majority still come from the diet. But in vegans, for example, this could be a very important source.
So prebiotics are compounds found in food. They influence the growth and beneficial microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi. They're essentially food for the probiotics. Prebiotics are found in high fiber foods such as fruits, vegetables, whole grains. So the more you eat, the more it helps the good bacteria in your gut. Examples include garlic, onions, asparagus, bananas, oats, apples. They are not digested by our human body, but this fiber instead is digested by our bacteria. and they can grow and thrive, leading to healthier balance of gut flora. The benefits of prebiotics are they can improve the absorption of minerals, weight management, immune functions. But if you eat too much of this fiber, it can lead to gas, bloating, discomfort.
Prebiotics are resistant to digestion. They get eaten by the bacteria and provide fermentation, and they promote the good, healthy bacteria. So it's essentially food that can pass through our stomachs that the bacteria love to eat. This causes better digestion, better immune function, reduced inflammation, and there's a lot of different types. They're usually found in high fiber foods.
Probiotics, on the other hand, are the actual live microorganisms that, when administered in high enough amounts, they can confer health benefits to the host. They're found in foods like yogurt, kefir, sauerkraut, tempeh, miso, so vitamin K2. We talk a lot about something called natto and miso soup. Check those videos down below. These microorganisms can colonize our gut and help restore natural balances of gut flora.
A probiotic, this is a live organism that you consume in a capsule. It can help balance the gut composition. We want to focus on the beneficial bacteria and organisms, and you want them to be doing good things in your gut. So there's various strains. If you get the right or good bacteria, your digestive health can improve, your immune function can improve, and they've specifically seen studies in IBS, Crohn's, inflammatory bowel disease, diarrhea, constipation, more regular poo. This is found in regular foods, so you don't need to take a capsule, but taking a prebiotic plus eating more fermented foods can be very beneficial as well, or you can take the probiotic capsules.
This makes a huge difference for me. When you watch these videos, if you're taking a prebiotic or probiotic or both, tell me if it's helping. The feedback on these videos are as much as some of these studies. It makes a huge, huge difference. So help this video. Tell us. I respond to the comments. I look at all these. It makes a big difference for me. But antibiotics are the number one thing. I deal with a lot of bone infections, a lot of diabetic infections. And this is the number one reason this comes up for me is I dispense a lot of antibiotics because people have abscesses, wounds that are not healing. And that's the one time they are definitely necessary so you don't lose your foot. But I've had patients after antibiotics where they can't sleep, they're fatigued, they're tired, they're beat up for weeks or months. Probiotics can aid in digestion, improve nutrient absorption, boost immunity, all the good things we've talked about. But too much can cause gassiness, bloating, and there's specific times you want to use it. Essentially, prebiotics are dietary fibers, which are food for the bacteria, whereas probiotics are the actual live bacteria that settle our gut. Prebiotics are stable and go through our stomach. They're not destroyed by heat or stomach acid to a relative extent. But probiotics, on the other hand, are very sensitive. Heat, if you left your pill bottle out on the counter, for example, for too long in the Florida heat, could kill it. Or number two, our stomach acids could kill it. The trick is to combine prebiotics and probiotics. This is a concept known as synbiotics. This combination ensures that probiotics have the necessary nutrients to thrive in the gut. Let's talk about
PreticX. PreticX
is a prebiotic xylo-oligosaccharide. So that's a mouthful. This is one that is a very popular supplement. It is known for its effectiveness in increasing the amounts of beneficial bacteria in the colon, specifically good bacteria, and these are identified as bifidobacteria. This type of bacteria plays a crucial role in proper digestion, aiding in nutrient absorption and disposal of toxins. One of the key features of
PreticX
is its stability, which allows it to be used in low doses. So essentially, it's cheap, you can take smaller doses, and it feeds your good gut bacteria. It's also known for being particularly stable and easy to use, making it a valuable ingredient in both food products and dietary supplements. So a study performed by UCLA have shown that
PreticX
can significantly modify gut microbiota. It helps growing more species of beneficial gut bacteria, reducing both bad bacteria and increasing healthy bacteria. They've found that very overweight individuals have a higher ratio of bad bacteria, but healthy people that eat a lot of fruit, a lot of fiber, have a higher ratio of good bacteria. And this is related to blood sugar too. Certain bacteria in our gut result in higher blood sugar. Other bacteria are correlated with lower blood sugar. I'm not going to say one causes or the other. It's just found in more obese and diabetic patients. Specifically,
PreticX
has been shown to lower the firmicutes and bacteroides ratio in the gut. An increased ratio of these bacteria is associated with overweight gut microbiota, suggesting that
PreticX
could play a role in managing obesity.
PreticX
is a non-GMO and is generally recognized as safe by the government. So it's not genetically modified, and it's generally recognized as safe by the government status. According to the studies,
PreticX
stands out as one of the better prebiotics. It's very beneficial in low doses. It's very stable in nature. That means you don't need to take a lot. It passes through a stomach acid. It's not going to get destroyed in the heat by leaving it out. It's a xylo-oligosaccharide, and it's been looked at in numerous studies. Essentially, what it comes down to is it's very cheap. Like, I looked at these bottles, they're like $10. And you take tiny little dose, and we'll go over the situations where it does help you at the end. So let's go over the
PreticX
studies that were recently performed. The first study was performed at UCLA, and they found that
PreticX
significantly modified the gut microbiome. It showed that
PreticX
lowered the bacteria that are high in obese, overweight, and high blood sugar individuals. And it's said for this reason that lowering these bacteria can help in weight loss management and lowering blood sugar. So they did a study where some people took the
PreticX
and some did not. It's not by a huge number, but their hemoglobin A1C did decrease. Their blood sugar did decrease. So between a comparison group and the group that took the prebiotic, it did help out. Was it a massive life-shattering amount? It was not, but it was a decent amount that made a difference. And for me, where this is noticeable, again, antibiotic people, diabetics that don't eat the proper diet that might have gassiness or stomach issues. Study number two, another aspect of
PreticX
research, combined green kiwi extract. In the clinical trial, it improved digestive health outcomes. People taking both the kiwi and the prebiotic showed significant improvement in the Bristol stool scales, which assess stool from digestive health compared to those taking a placebo or the green kiwi extract alone. A 2007 study was performed. This was a double-blind study. Now, granted, it was smaller numbers. It looked at 9 people who took the
PreticX
and 13 people who did not. They took a fake
PreticX,
so they did not know which one they were getting. The treatment group actually got 4 grams per day for 3 weeks, whereas the control group was given none. And this study looked at the fecal moisture content, the pH, the content of all the bacteria, the Clostridium perfringens, which is bad. So they looked at all the bacterial content. They actually went really in depth looking at the poop quality and the gut quality. The results showed that the prebiotic supplement group had significantly increased the population of good bacteria. The poo was essentially creamier. You're less likely to have constipation, less likely to have hemorrhoids, and it decreased the fecal pH value. So essentially your poo is a little bit more acidic. That means more bad stuff got taken out. The amount of nutrients, your blood levels, your GI functions, they could not really tell the difference. So essentially by taking the prebiotic, your poo was a lot creamier. It went out a lot easier. You were a little bit less gassy. Not a whole lot of huge other changes. A 2008 study in Taiwan looked at 26 patients with high diabetes. So the hemoglobin A1C was between 7.0 and 10, which is very diabetic for my patients. 4 grams per day were taken for 8 weeks. And this was a double-blinded study. Nobody knew which ones they were taking. And they both kept eating the exact same things afterwards as before. The prebiotic group actually had lower blood sugar, on average from 167 to 154, and the hemoglobin A1C decreased from 8.2 to 7.9, as well as the sugar concentrations, the cholesterol LDL levels, and the apolipoprotein B levels. By taking the prebiotic, or fiber in this case, the blood sugar did decrease in the group and heads up. Again, not huge numbers, but they never are huge numbers. All of these studies seem to positively correlate to the benefit of taking a prebiotic. In 2014, the Food and Function Journal, they did a 3-group test. One group had 0 grams of the prebiotic, One group had 1.4 grams daily, and the third group had 2.8 grams dose for 12 weeks. The good bacteria increased the most in the 2.8 gram group with no significant side effects. So essentially the poo quality improved and the good bacteria improved. So the bottom line is, while it doesn't make massive life-altering changes, it can drop your blood sugar, it does make your poo creamier, you're less constipated, it can stabilize your stomach digestion a little bit, and it's relatively cheap. Like, when you look at the supplement, it's like less than $10 for these doses for a decent amount of time.
Or PreticX
benefits over the other prebiotics that were compared and studied. It's more effective at a lower dose, and it's pretty cheap. So the bottom line is, why take this thing? I'm not promoting any prebiotics or probiotics, but who benefits this? This is people who should consider trying a prebiotic or probiotic. And I do have a video that goes more in depth about probiotics. This is our prebiotic video. But if you have irritable bowel syndrome, inflammatory bowel disease, a chronic constipation disorder, a prebiotic can really make a big difference. So if you're really gassy, or your husband or your wife slip a little bit into their, no, don't do that. I'm gonna get in trouble. But the big one for me is after antibiotic use. Antibiotic use is sky high now in our society. We're developing super bacteria. There's more and more resistance, but antibiotics can disrupt the natural gut biome. This is what I see. It causes severe problems, lethargy, not being able to sleep, weakness. I've seen so much, this stuff is underreported for sure. The stuff that I see, try a prebiotic. It's like, 10 bucks for hardly anything. It is definitely worth trying. Those with poor diet or nutritional imbalances, look, if you're a diabetic, if you're trying a lot of different stuff, maybe try the prebiotics. It can make a big difference. If you have issues with allergies or immune responses, some studies do suggest that pre and probiotics can modulate the immune system, potentially benefiting autoimmune diseases or allergies. Why not try it? There's not a whole lot of risk. If you're desperate, test it out. Individuals with mental health, there are some studies that essentially show there's a gut-brain axis, and pro and prebiotics can improve mood and well-being. I have seen this happen quite a bit, especially after antibiotics. People get depressed afterwards, but then they can feel a lot better. Especially magnesium, vitamin D, I see that so much where people correct some of these deficiencies and imbalances. Older adults as well, if you're constipated, if you have issues going to the bathroom, try a prebiotic. If you're having a ton of infections, especially Clostridium difficile. Now, the one thing that I see in the hospital is a fecal transplant. They actually take someone else's poo and put it in you to restore your gut bacteria after you've taken too much antibiotics. First, I would try a prebiotic and probiotic, see which one helps the most. And there are some studies showing it can help with the digestion and metabolisms of certain foods. So vitamin K2, vitamin B12 as well. And if you have certain conditions like leaky gut, especially patients here who drink a lot of alcohol, prebiotics might be worth trying. Personally, my gut health is great. I feel really good. I don't go out of my way to take this stuff, but I've had so many patients who have had these issues. The antibiotics, the lethargy, the constant bloating, the irritable bowel syndrome. I know in college when I used to drink a lot of alcohol, this would have definitely benefit me. We're talking a couple bucks. We're talking extremely low doses. We're talking very low side effect profile. And if it does irritate you, stop taking it. It's definitely worth trying. Check out my links below. I link some of these below. See if it helps. This makes a huge difference for me. When you watch these videos, if you're taking a prebiotic or probiotic or both, tell me if it's helping. The feedback on these videos are as much as some of these studies. It makes a huge, huge difference. So help this video. Tell us. I respond to the comments. I look at all these. It makes a big difference for me.